in the world of basketball with the draft this Thursday. A lot of teams are making moves, and it looks like Phil Jackson and the Knicks are looking to do the same. Jackson is considering trading Porzingis, and he has a backup plan. The Knicks have the 8th pick in the draft, and if they do decide to get rid of Porzingis, he'll be looking to pick up Lauri Markkanen, which is basically like a mini Porzingis. He's another demigod, 7 foot, 255. He's from Finland. He's 20 years old. But the question is, if you have Porzingis, why trade Porzingis to get another Porzingis? Why not keep Porzingis and draft somebody else to complement Porzingis? Maybe that makes too much sense. I don't know. It's very frustrating to be a Knicks fan. You've already got the owner. There's a lot of drama there. Then you've got Phil Jackson. He's openly dissing his star player, Carmelo Anthony. NBA players don't want to come to New York when they see that happening. And then Phil Jackson is still trying to run the triangle offense in 2017. And it's a shame because New York, the mecca of basketball, the reason why they brought Phil Jackson is to return the franchise back to winning, to get back to the playoffs. And that hasn't happened. It might have even gotten worse. I don't know. The Knicks in the past, they've had a lot of problems, like overpaying their players, crazy contracts. Well, Phil Jackson gave a crazy contract to Joakim Noah. That wasn't a smart idea. Noah was declining as a player. That looks like the same type of deal the Knicks would have done before Phil Jackson was there. So it's really weird because Porzingis, when he drafted him, a lot of people at the time, they thought it was a bad selection. If you remember on draft night, a lot of the fans were crying, booing. But he's been a pleasant surprise. He's done pretty well so far. It's weird that, you know, you would consider trading him when he turned out to be a pretty good gamble in the draft. Phil Jackson met with Lauri, the prospect he's thinking of taking, on Monday. Let me know what you think if you're a Knicks fan. If you're just a fan of the NBA, what do you think about this situation developing? Should the Knicks start all over, rebuild again, just start from scratch right now, or should they just repair the lineup, build around Carmelo and Porzingis? Let me know in the comment section. Well, I got into a fight.